Hi viewers, this is Dr. G. Jana and I welcome you to this video lectures on data science part 2, and we will be focusing on Hadoop and big data, and we will study in details the followings. First one, what is the importance of Hadoop and big data? Some introduction, why it is important, or what are the importance of this Hadoop. Then we'll know what are the softwares and tools we'll be using, and mainly we'll be requiring Java. SJDK we need it here, that is from Oracle. You can just log into this Oracle and download this. I have gone for this JDK 1.8.0_291. Different versions are there, you can go for that one, but anyway this is also stable versions you can use. I already what the entire program what I'll be doing using this one, that's why I'm telling you. Then next we go for downloading the software Hadoop -3.3.0, because this is the latest. Anyway, that another version is that 3.3.1. I have not tested, maybe blocks will be there, but 3.3.0 it is tested, so you can go for that one. Then we can go for some installation and configurations. Here we go for some configurations of these files. There also we will be going for Hadoop configuration 3.3.0. I will tell you the procedure how to do that one. Then afterwards we will be going for running some of the program, one program on this Hadoop program, right? So now let us discuss about the introduction part or the importance of this Hadoop. See, Hadoop is a framework, or we can say it is a platform, and it is not a software. You people confuse that Hadoop is a software. It is a framework or it is a platform, we can say. And it was started in the year 2005, idea by Google, and it is based on the distributed computing. So this is the main thing we must have some understanding. And it is open source and provided by Apache Hadoop. Clear? Then now the commercial versions as Cloudera is available. They will be using the same thing, but the difference is that there will be afterwards support, but while it is open source, when you stock up or there is a problem, that you won't get any support. That is the only difference. Otherwise they will be using the same thing. And Hadoop has the architecture of MapReduce, which is a default program framework on the top of this Hadoop. So these are the some of the important things of this Hadoop. Then we see the background. We must have the expertise on Java, Python. So these help you in the Spark. While you are going for this programming Spark, that will help you. So let us start from the scratch. We generally use the relational database management system or the RDBMS, like MySQL, Oracle, etc. And the purpose is to store data in rows and columns. Just like the transactions in the banking system, the transactions, etc. But when the data starts growing or increasing, it creates a problem for retrieving and processing. Okay, say we take an example of Oracle. Say in Oracle, we have the storage module and we have the database engine. Okay, so one is used for storage, one is used for the all the other query language, etc. If the storage increases, what will happen? So we have the limitations for storage. We can create boxes, and as boxes increases, it divides our data. Not divide middly, just exactly divide into two halves, but it divides data into some different places. And there is a possibility of duplications, and to remove this duplication, we go for the normalization. The normalizations mainly used for to remove the duplications. And when you fire a query, we have to go for joining the tables or the relations, what we say. Say for terabyte of data with join query, we have to wait, and sometimes it fails also. You get it now? So this is the limitations. Then what we do? Then we go for the partitioning our boxes. So one table is logically partitioned. For example, we take what are the drawbacks. Say we are having some country-wide data for any, let it be that some company or some work is there. Okay, say India has 2 terabyte of data, USA have 5 terabyte, and Nepal has only 500 kilobyte. Then what will happen when we are going for the first two countries? It takes less time, it takes long time for accessing, for processing. But in case of the country like Nepal, only very less data is there, so it takes very less time. So query takes longer time for huge data. That is the conclusion we come here. Next in RDBMS, if data size increases, the process becomes slow. That is the one of the disadvantages of the RDBMS. Then we may go for denormalization. Here all data in one table is maintained. Then it is difficult to maintain all the data in one table. You get it now? So the size will be very big, and again there is some limitations. If only structured data is there, that means in the rows and columns, like the Excel sheets you are maintaining, it is okay. But for unstructured data, like the images, audio, etc., there is a problem and it cannot be processed. If table is big, we go for this clustering also. So let us take an example. Say Flipkart is selling some iPhone X, say for example, and there are 10 million product and each having 10 images, say total 1 billion images. Here it is not possible to process it using this RDBMS. You get it now? So this is the limitations. Then we go for NoSQL database like MongoDB, like the Cascade Cassandra. These are used for this unstructured data. Say organizations like Amazon, they use DynamoDB with concept of key and value pair. Here the data is not stored like the SQL, like the the row and columns. Instead it is used as key and value, and all the entire data is maintained like that. So store and retype of unstructured data is fast. With NSPD you can do that one also. And here there is no concept of rows and columns. Say in this iPhone X, we take this iPhone X, the model, as the key. Then the remaining details will be taken as the value. Then you type some iPhone 10 or iPhone 11, something like that. Then all these details, it will come in the value. We'll take an example. Say you are booking the cab using this Ola. There are 40 million of customers are using. If all book the cab or car at the same time, so 40 million concurrent session, it is impossible to process, and it takes sometimes hours and days. So by that time the customer will be leaving and making alternate arrangement to leave. Then the scalability of this relational database management system, the price of Oracle also, it is costly in comparison to this, because it is not only storage. Company also needs to collect and analyze for some real-time applications. For example, Amazon and Flipkart, for online ordering, they track from which IP address the customer is accessing and how long he is accessing and which items they are going through, the images, and based on this they give some offer to attract the customer for some marketing. Get it now? Suppose you want to do it using this RDBMS concept, it takes sometimes hour, days. By that the customer will be leaving, so it will be no useful for real-time applications. By the alternate the big data. Here huge amount of data which is not processed in traditional method are used. Then what is this RDBMS used for? It is used for only solutions for transaction management, for example Oracle, okay, because it is satisfying the ACID property, atomicity, like that, all these properties, you know, durability, integrity, concurrency, like that, all the things are there. So for that atomicity, you know, atomicity, suppose you are going for a transaction in the middle, it is disrupted, so the either the entire transaction is to be carried out or it has to roll back or none, right? So these are some of the things why we are going for that one. Then suppose we go for one e-commerce website using the NoSQL database. Here million of people book flight tickets, so for example. In NoSQL database, we use the concept like ETL, E is for extract, T is for transform, and L is for load. Extract, transform, and load. Say, you take the example of banking companies. The CRM data, CRM is the customer relation management, that is maintained by MySQL, say for example. At core banking data, that is maintained by this Oracle. So these are the different type of data. Suppose XML files are there also, the partners and other company they will be using, and the Facebook, they are using the JSON data, then JavaScript object notation like that. Okay, so that is the key value based on this key value. Then the customer care log file, then the flat files like the text files, the chat log, the call log, all this data. This is not that simply you can maintain Excel data, what is the name of the customer, what is the age of the customer, what is the account number, it is not like that. So it can be audio, it can be video, it can be this type of data. Here they collect all data and dump in a central place, and we call it the data warehousing. Here Oracle cannot do analytics using these things, and customer cannot directly access this data warehousing. So on the other hand, what it does, the ETL tools take the data and dump to data warehouse, and it can go for the processing. Any executive officer of any company, he can go for analyzing the business intelligence using the Tableau, OLAP, and all things they can do it there. So this is some of the importance why you are going for this data science, right? Then the next thing we go for, how do we go for procedure to install the install and configuration the Hadoop? So we have divided into three parts. In the part one, I told you that what are the software you require. We require mainly Java, we require Hadoop. Two things are required. So in this Java, we get from Oracle Java AC Dev Kit 8. So usually I will be using 8 in my system here. I am using a Windows 10 64 bit operating system. So I am recommending you can go for JDK 1.8.0_291. So these are the versions you can, because as per my system configurations, I downloaded this one. It is compatible. I don't have an issue. I tried 261. Some problem was there. That's why I tried and tested. It is working. So it is available, but it is not restricted. You can use any version. But remember that 8 and 11 is compatible with the Hadoop 3.30. Other versions I have not tested. Maybe it is not compatible also. Right? Then immediately, then how you do all the things? Then I will show you how do you go for those things. Just you type the Java in the Google, in the Google you type the google.com, and then you search it that oracle.com Java, some technology like that, you can go for that one. And you can see you try Java AC, Java 8U211 Latron, like that. So these are the things your screen will appear like this. Once it appears, you see 291 is the latest version of the JDK 8, so it is coming. Then what you have to do, so it is for different operating system it is available. You are using Windows, suppose you are using Windows 64 bit, if it is 32 bit, you have to go for this one. If it is 64 bit, you have to go for Windows X64. Then it is around 168.67 MB, and you have to download this one, EX version, JDK-8U-291, Windows-X64 EX. Just click it here. Once you click it, it will download. And once it downloads, then what you need to install. Just double click and install. But remember, while you are installing, by default it will be installed. Yeah, I'm coming back here. By default it will be installed in the C program file Java. Like that it will be created. But usually you can go for the C Java. I had some problem with my C drive, because nearly it is filled. Only 10% is 20% it is there. So instead of what I did, I installed in my D drive. Then what I did, the path setting, I have given the initially while I am installing or downloading D Java. Under this D drive, I created a folder Java. There I am downloading. Okay, what I downloaded? D Java JDK 1.8.0_291. Then I clicked it there and I am running it there. Okay. Just to put it everything. Okay. By default, there is nothing to worry. Only I told you that where you have to install the path I have given. This version I have to do. Now go to the command prompt. Then you type java-version, it will show you the version, and Java C enter. You see, I'm showing it here. Suppose I am going for typing the CMD. I'm typing the command prompt here and enter it here. So I want to check the Java version. Just type java-version, version, and enter it here. You can find Java version 1.8.0_291. It is already installed. It's clear. So now you can check it is running or not. For that you type Java C. So once you click it here, you can see it is also running, right? So before that, it will not run directly. You have to go for the path setting. How do you go for the path setting? Especially in a Windows 10 platform, how do you go for this platform? You can see my PC there. You can see in the my PC, just right click here. Then you go to the properties. In the properties, you see here advanced settings systems. Advanced system settings. The advanced system, once you click, then you can see the environment variables. Once you click the environment variable, then you can see it here. One is the user variables, one is the system variables. One is the user variable, one is the system variable. Then what you do, the first time you create a new, I created a new. Here you type Java underscore home. That already I have done here, you can see it here. Java underscore home. Then where the Java is installed, you have to go there. Because mine is installed in D drive, Java, JDK, something it is there. So then that one, you copy that path, the same thing, and paste it in the variable value. Understand? Variable name is Java underscore, just I'm cancelling it here. Java underscore home is the variable name, and the value is equal to D, Java, JDK, these are things. Is it clear? Is it clear? Up to this, you have completed all the things. Okay? Then immediately what you have to do, you go to the system variables, there you go to the path. There you go to the path. Path will be by default there. There is no need to create a new path. Path is there. You go to the edit. Just you go to the edit path. In this edit path, you create a new one. You create a new one because I already done. So just I'm showing you. In this new one, I am showing, I just put it here D Java JDK 1.8.0/bin. Just I put it here. Is it clear? Then you, in the new, already you set it here. Then you, okay, where you get it, you go to the path and auto bin, you copy and paste it here, it is okay. Then similar thing also, that also for Hadoop, that is different things, I will come again, but Java is there. So once it is okay up to this and everything is set, now your Java is ready. Once Java is ready, then you can run all these commands, what I run it right now. So using this run command, you can see Java is running and you can write CLS, you can clear the screen. Then I clear the screen. It's clear? Now, this was all about downloading, selecting the correct version of Java, downloading, installing, and path setting of Java. I hope you are following. Then immediately what we go for that one, we will be going for the next part, that is the Hadoop, that we are going for the Hadoop, okay? Then we go to the hadoop.apache.org, that also I'll show you. You can come here, you can go for hadoop.apache.org 3.30, those things are there. You can see download tar.gz, gunzip. Okay, so just click it there and it will download. Already I have downloaded. Then unzip it using it, gz or whatever the your tar you are having, rar file, you unzip it that one. After one installations, what will have? You'll have Hadoop 3.3.0. How you'll get it, that also I'm showing. So you'll have something like that. I am taking you to my D drive where I installed all the things. Then here you find it here. Then while you are going for this Hadoop software, you will have something like that, Hadoop-3.3.0. This is the software. Okay, then what you need to do, for I have given the reference of all the things. You can have the JDK 8U291. This is the software you needed, that you can put it there. Then Hadoop 3.3.0, that also you download, and you that you unzip. Just you unzip means that you extract it there, that you copy and paste it there in the D drive, because you will be downloading it, will be there in the download folder. Once you extract the Hadoop 3.3.0, this copy and paste in the D, because everything I'm maintaining in the D drive. You can see my C drive less space is there, that is the problem. In my C drive space is very less. Yeah, I close it here, I'll show you my C drive very less space. That is the reason. You see 3.460, it is now I have to clear something, because so many software is there, otherwise it will not work. You got it now? So in this way I was using my D drive. Now in the D drive I have shown you, first of all, in the Hadoop software, JDK already you downloaded, installed. Then Hadoop 3.30, after extracting here, this one you copied and pasted in D drive separately. This is only the software, it is not. Then you have to download another thing, that is 3.30 configuration files Hadoop underscore program. So these configuration files, you can get it there. It is around 4.95 MB. That also you would have to extract. After extracting, whatever the important things, you need it here. There. Then for using some software, for running some program, I have already gone the mapreduce.client.rar file, as well as the input file, that I have done. then already I have given you the procedure how to do all the things, right? So with this, what you have done, we have here, now we have gone for this Hadoop also. This Hadoop is there in D Hadoop 3.3.0. okay, then what you need to do, then what is the download 3.3.0 configuration file, what I have shown you there, you double click there and you find some bin file. Then the existing D Hadoop 3.30, there will be some bin file, there will be some bin file. Delete this existing file, and what you copied from this configuration 3.3.0, that the same thing, and paste it here. Again, I am repeating, Hadoop 3.3.0 you already downloaded and extracted and you put in D drive. So if you double click there in the D drive Hadoop 3.3.0, you will have some bin file. This bin file you don't need, you delete that one. Okay, then now the 3.3.0 configuration file for the Hadoop, now you downloaded and extracted, you double click there, you after entering, you enter to Hadoop, then you get another bin file. Same bin file copy here and paste it here inside this Hadoop 3.3.0. Get it now? Now the next part is there. First I will explain, then we will go after doing all those things. Then go to the D drive Hadoop 3.3.0. You will have a number of folders. Then you check the etc folder. In this etc folder, there are so many files, but you, for the configurations, you need the 5 files to be configured. First one is core-site.xml, then hdfs.xml, then mapreduce.xml, then yarn-site.xml, and hadoop-environment.cmd file. So 1, 2, 3, 4, these 5 files are there. Okay. So once you find all the things, then up to this, it is fine. Then you take a break and we'll go to how do you go for the configuration of all the things. For these configurations, what we do, yeah, we can go to the D drive where I'm showing my softwares are there. In the D drive, you go for the Hadoop software. In the Hadoop software, I have given you a configuration file, procedure Hadoop installation, then edit Hadoop configuration. Okay, here, if you check it here, I have given you all the 5 files and how to go for. First file, you go for D Hadoop 3.3.0, go to the etc folder. In the etc folder, Hadoop will be there. There core-site. Okay, you don't confuse, I'm showing you there also. Then things will be clarified, because simply telling story theories, you cannot do all the things. Then I am going to the my PC. Then I am going to my D drive. In the D drive, already I am having Hadoop 3.3.0. Then you are having etc folder. In this etc folder, you are having Hadoop. In this Hadoop, you are having all the files. So you can see core-site, this is the XML file. Can you see it here? Similarly, Hadoop environment, this is a CMD file, window command file. Similarly, you can have HDFS site, HDFS, it is an XML file. Get it now? Similarly, MapReduce, you are having MapReduce here also, so MapReduce hyphen site, this is also XML file. Like that, whatever the yarn hyphen environment, something like that also, it will be there also. Sorry, yarn hyphen site XML file is there. So now, what you do, so before that, if you see that Sublime or something, it is some editor is installed there. If it is already installed, then what you need to do, suppose I want to go one by one, what I have to do. So here, first I am going for core-site.xml. Just to right click that folder there and open with Sublime, then it will open. Then in the configuration, this configuration and closing configuration tag, it will be there, but in between it will be empty. Then copy this property, name is equal to fs.default.name, then hdfs localhost 9000, all the things copy and paste it there. I already copied and pasted there, that I am going to show you. Say now I am going for, what is the core site, it was there. Then I open with say my Sublime. Now see, even if you are opening, it is not that file. For that, what you do, because Sublime, it will be showing some other places, because previously I was working on this R programming, the same folder it is showing. You have to go to the file, then you have to open folder. In this open folder, then you go to D drive. In the D drive, Hadoop 3.3.0 is there, then select the folder. Now you can see, now in this select folder, Hadoop 3.3.0, you are having the etc folder, then you are having the Hadoop folder, in this Hadoop folder core site.xml is there. In the core site.xml, what I told you that by default opening tag configuration and closing tag configuration will be there. Then from that sheet, you copy the entire thing configuration to closing configuration, the property name, everything copy and paste it here. This is the only thing you are doing here in core site.xml, right? So after core site.xml modifying these things, then what is the next thing you are going to do in the B? You are going for map reduced site XML. Map reduced site XML. So you go to the map reduced site XML. Map reduced. Is it the correct thing? Yeah, is the correct thing. Then sorry. This word close. This is not required. Okay. Then I go for this map reduce. I have to. Don't worry, so I'm coming for this one. Then, oh my god, this is creating error. Okay, then I have to go for this map reduce. Where is the map reduce? JHIJK map reduce site.xml. Go here. Then, what I've done there also from configuration to configuration, whatever the file I'm providing the text file, just copy and map reduce. Dot framework dot name, it is coming under name, the value it is coming earn, okay, and it is inside the property opening tag closing tag, just you change it there. Okay, so this also you change it there. What is the third point? This is I am talking about the configuration. In the configuration, see, we are going for this ABC map reduced is already there. Then we are going for HDFS site. I am going for that one. Okay, then before that you can go for this yarn site XML also, you can go for that. So while we go for this yarn site, you come on here, then you go for the yarn site.xml. Here also yarn dot, you see same thing I have given all the file, just copy and paste, say 15 to 24, just by default only two line will be there, open tag configuration, closing tag configuration. So then copy there everything and paste it here. You got it now? So now you can understand all things there. There are lot of materials is there. So now name value property name value close property, all things, this is the configurations part, just you change it, right? So once everything it is done, then you go for the HDFS site.xml. in this HDFS site.xml, in the HDFS not this HDFS, this is HDFS, it will be there, just HDFS site.xml. Say here also you need to do one thing, because before this you have to do something. You have to go to the D drive, then in that D drive go to the Hadoop hyphen 3.3.0. inside that folder you create another folder data. Okay, create a folder data. Inside the data folder you create one name node folder and one data node folder. This is the things you have to do before coming to this file. You got it now? I'll show you what to do. So just go to the D drive. Just enter into the Hadoop hyphen 3.30. inside that right click and create a new folder, that is the folder name is data. Okay, and inside this data folder you create another two folder, one is the name node folder and another is the data node folder. You know how to create folders, that you do. It's because window based you don't have any problem. Then once you have done, then you are opening this HDFS hyphen site.xml. there you write all the things, because this configuration also I have given and everything is there, right? Then another thing will be there, that is the Hadoop environment or CMD. This part, two or three things you have to change it here. So while you are going for the Java underscore home, by default some other things will be there. You go to what is the path, D Java JDK, no bin is required, remember. Set all the things, if any at the rate, that remove that one. So set this one is there, and the at the end, by default the username is my user, Hadoop underscore ident underscore string, that you write the my user. So here you change in the last but one line, there you change, this is the thing. With the changing, whatever doing, just save it. If you saved everything and everything is fine, then you close all the things. Okay, then what is the name you do next? Everything you have done successfully, then this one also you close, then this one also you close, we don't need this one. And finally you come on here, what is our procedure, let us go. So this is already here. Okay,
then what you need to do, then is telling you go to the command prompt. In the command prompt, open with the administrator mode. How you do that one? See, that also will show, because if you don't open as administrator, then it will show some problem. So what you need to do, just click it here, type cmd, and instead of entering, just right click it here and run as administrator. Can you check it here? Then it will ask you, this is verified plumber, sir. You say yes, it is, I wanted this one. Now you are there. So once you are here, you have to run this command. What is that command? See, the command is HDFS name node hyphen format. So type it, HDFS space name node, NAME NODE, name node space hyphen format. Okay, so once you type it here and enter, you can see it is coming. It takes some time, but it will come. Yeah, you can see everything is running successfully. It's clear, still it is running, and everything is running successfully. You got it now? So it is, because already I have done this one, it is asking, do you want to format? Yes, I want to format it again also. Yes, so it has done everything successfully. You have done. So once you have done, you remember, now you are by default in CU Windows System 32, but your Hadoop is in a different place. So for that, what you need to do, because mine is in D drive, D:Enter, you are in D drive, then it is cd space Hadoop hyphen 3.3.0 / I have to go for the sbin folder, sbin. Once I enter it here, you can see you are already there in the sbin folder. Once you are there in the sbin folder, then you have to start the DFS and you have to start the yarn also. For starting, you can write this one, start hyphen dfs dot cmd, or without cmd also it will take. So start DFS and start yarn. See, I am running it here. Start hyphen DFS, I am running. See, it is automatically opening. See, so many things it is running. You see, minimum, yeah, running. So if it is not closing, not shutting down, that means it is running successfully. Ours is, everything is successful and it is running. You can see it here. Then what I have done, then I have given, I have to give another thing, that the start yarn, start hyphen yarn. Okay, so here two already started, another two will be starting. Start yarn, just enter it here. So another two open and it is running. Everything is running successfully. You got it now? Now you can see everything is running and it is waiting for the instruction, what next it has to do. Clear? So these are the things you have done, the singleton, everything there, formatted and started. You got it now? So yeah, still running. It takes some time, don't worry, and minimize all the things. So don't worry for these things, it has done successfully. So one, this is two, this is three, and this is four. Okay, then you are here. So you want to see what are the nodes running, and just you type JPS, type it here. So what are the nodes ready, it will show you there. It is showing you are having resource manager is ready, node manager is ready, name node is there ready, and JPS is ready. All are ready. You got it now? So now when all the things are ready, then what next, what you have to do? That means all your server, it is running successfully, and then you have to check it with any of the browser. I go to this browser here. In this browser, what I need to do, I close all things, is not necessary. This also you close it, and it is not necessary. Then you go for this local host. In the local host, first you go for the 9870. If you run this 9870, you can clearly see it is running. Can you see? Everything is successful, it is running. The started October 2, today is October 2. So all this is the timing. I think it is the 12:16. So 12:14, whatever time is there, it is running. So now it is running. So because what time the server started, that time it is showing, not the, when you are watching the browser, it will not show that time. You got it now? Now everything is running successfully. You can see everything, it is successfully running. Okay, similarly, another thing also, you can localhost 80886. So you go for localhost, you can go for here 8086, but anyway you type it, don't worry for that one, it is there or not there. 8, it will come 8088, right? So this is the thing. So once you click it here, yes, you can see Hadoop is also, it is running, but there is no data available here. I have not gone for any data. Now up to this you are able to install and configure Hadoop successfully. Thank you for watching this video. If you really like this video, please share with your friends and don't forget to subscribe. And in the next part we are going for running a Hadoop program, and we'll do that one, and I'll tell you the commands how to stop all the things also. You don't worry for this. Now we can close all the things. Now I stop it here. Then what I have to do, so for stopping all the things, yeah, you can go for this thing here for stopping. So how you started the DFS, you have to go for stop directly, don't close, it will corrupted. Stop hyphen DFS. Now you see two of the things it will be closed. Yeah, it is closing this thing successfully. This and this, it is closed. Then stop yarn, stop stop hyphen yarn, yarn. So this is also it is stopping. So yeah, now you see all are closed, only except this one, all are closed. Okay, so if you have completed successfully, just exit it, exit. And once again thank you for watching this video, and I will be sharing all the things with you. If you really like these things, please do share with your friends, and also don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching this video. Take care of yourself. Thank you.